Many years ago, I journeyed with the Maharaja of India to the Island of Time, intending to play and see what we discovered. It's all deserted, and its guardians gone to sleep. Its walls which spoke of an empress, of time. But of this enigmatic creature, there was no trace. We returned to India with treasure nonetheless. A staff, a dagger, an empty hourglass covered in jewels, and books. Such secrets they contained. For even then, I was an older man. Knew that my time would soon be at an end. The books showed me that life eternal was not beyond my reach, but it required the essence of the empty itself. The power of the sun. But you were gone. They were gone. And so I thought. I turned my attention towards other pursuits and left that dream behind. 4 weeks ago, the dagger stirred and showed me things. Whispered to me in my sleep. It drew me here, towards Babylon. Alas, the Maharaja did not share my vision. Would not grant me leave. So I slew him and claimed his kingdom, his army for my own. Nothing would stand between me and my desire.
Recklessly, the prince drew his weapon and charged forward, intending to rescue me. It was as if he had learned nothing from his past adventures. Or perhaps he'd simply forgotten, made blind and deaf by fear and rage. This is how it happened. This is how I died.
No!
What have we here?
The vizier!
Ah, you must be the Prince of Persia. Come home at last. Too late, I'm afraid. I believe I have something of yours.
No!
Immortal! Father, forgive what I have done. Wherever you are.
Continue my story from here if you are called away. Should I continue from here when you return? Oh!
Once more, the wheels of suffering are set in motion by my hand. In taking Kylina from the Island of Time, I've changed the course of history. Without the Sands of Time, I never journeyed to Azad, never killed the Vizier. Now he lives again, driven by the same mad desire. I promise no harm would come to...
Is this where I should resume the tale next time?
Being pushed deeper into the palace and further from my enemy. My arm! What's happening? What has the Vizier done to me? I don't...
Everything had come full circle. The prince had resurrected his greatest enemy. Worse, he had accidentally delivered me into the man's hands. Unleashing a nightmare plague across Babylon. As if this was not enough, the prince had nearly been transformed by the Sands himself. Though he had avoided death, he had not escaped entirely untouched.
Wake up, prince. Wake up. Wake up! The way behind you is gone, so you'll have to find another exit from these sewers. Be quick about it. Start moving.
What? Who is there?
Be careful. The planks are slick. Mind your balance. Like the light.
Huh?
Call it what you want. You've been given the ability to destroy your enemies. Now use it.
What benefit is this? Even as I fight them, I grow weaker.
Kill them then. Let their lives reflect yours. It's good for us. Lead them into the light! Strike while they are blind! If you want it to be.
I do not.
But you will.
Why, then, is this happening to me?
You have been infected by the sands of time, as I am sure you have noticed. Maybe it's the dagger. Maybe it's all the time you've spent amongst the sands. Or amongst the Empress. Either way, you are resisting it. Mostly.
Mostly?
You did just transform into something rather unique, so I think the word is quite appropriate. Think of it this way. You have been given a gift. You're stronger, faster.
Uglier.
Now.
That explains the transformation. But who are you?
Have you not realized? I am your untapped potential, your unrealized dreams. I am part of you.
You're inside me?
Seems to fight this corruption. Why did you hide this from me?
What? And ruin all the fun?
Continue my story from here. Good. This is a fine place to start the tale.